You're listening to VPR, Velsen Public Radio.
First row, you are out of tune. The Emperor will be here soon, and he will not be as forgiving as I. Again! We must double our efforts. We must be in tune. Like this.
Lord Vader, you are out of tune. Will the Imperial Singers be ready for the 50th episode of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and MrBubble, or won't they?
Yes, Master, they will be ready.
Good. You must find new ways to motivate them.
Yes, Master.
And what of the cake?
Yivvits and MrBubble will have cake, Master.
Good. Good, Lord Vader. Will it be buttercream frosting?
Yes, Master.
Ha, very good. And what about reports of people calling to wish them congratulations?
They called or died, Master.
Excellent. All is going according to my plan. It is I who allowed Yivvits and MrBubble to reach 50 episodes, and it is I who ordered that pitiful cake. Lord Vader! Sense you wish to use a more appropriate tune.
Yes, Master.
Perhaps something like this.
Hey, welcome to the 50th episode of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and MrBubble. Today's Saturday, July 15th, and even though 1 year ago, Yivvits and I thought we'd maybe do one or two of these things, look at this! Oh, and my. I'm MrBubble.
I'm Yivvits, and we're still here.
Ah, we're still trapped.
Hoy.
This spiraling
oy,
thing.
Oy.
Spiraling out of control.
It is out of control.
But no, this is it. If you're listening to the first one, or if you've listened to all 49... First of all, I pity you if you listen to 49.
You have less of a life than we do.
Right. That tells me that you are really either in prison or...
We don't want to say that because they...
Okay. You are blessed if you've listened to all 49. You are one of...
Privileged.
You are one of the most blessed creatures on this earth.
Privileged.
Totally. We are friends.
Still. After 50.
Barely. Yeah, still.
Yeah. It's around the edge right now.
Still there. It's some may say like, questionable, but nah, I consider Yivvits a friend still.
50.
Okay? He's on my friends list.
Oh, good.
I don't always answer his tells.
Yeah. Add ignore me on weekends.
We're on each other's tells list, I hope. We are friends who play Star Wars Galaxies. It's one of those games you buy in the store. We say this every week. Yeah. But you buy in the store. It's still out there. I looked last week. It's still in the store.
You can still buy it, huh?
Mm-hmm.
That's amazing.
Yep. It's like $20 or whatever, and it costs $15 a month to play.
They just haven't been able to get rid of those copies, have they? They're flying off the shelf because of us, though.
Yeah, they have to. I'm sure they have to stock a dozen every day or something.
They need to have a questionnaire like the EB Electronic, or, you know, Electronics Boutique. Where did you hear about Star Wars Galaxies?
Oh, right.
Well, I heard this podcast. It was great.
We should put an identifying mark on each one just to see how long they're on the shelf.
Yeah. Say no. That's a good
idea. Can I borrow some of your business cards?
No.
Okay, that'd be great. No. Just tape your business card on each one.
You could use some of Ralph Stanley's business cards.
Oh, yeah, right. Okay, it's a game you buy in the store. It's like World of Warcraft or EverQuest or Ultima Online.
Ultima.
All those things.
Oh, that's old.
This is cooler. This is droids and Star Wars. Star Wars.
Yeah,
we talk about that
Star Wars.
And we talk about Star Wars, oddly enough. We talk about what we did in the game, and just, yeah, just whatever.
Jibber jabber. We jibber jabber.
Jibber jabber.
Yeah.
We install our Jabba client.
Yeah.
All right.
A Jabba client?
A Jabba Nobata.
You know, I heard that the Jabba language is really going to, is cross-platform. It's going to simplify everything.
You know, that's you can, Java, brother.
Oh.
But I think you're right about Hadees, too.
Okay.
You want to read a disclaimer so we can just unleash the pigeons here?
Oh, gosh. We've had this for 50 episodes.
But this is important. Our lawyers say this is very important.
Yeah, our lawyers, which consist of, what, a cat?
Meow. You can do that. Meow.
Oh, no problem.
Just give me Meow Mix.
Meow Mix.
Maybe some Pounce.
We have nothing to do with Lucasfilms, LucasArts, or Sony Online Entertainment. All parodies and impersonations are for comedic effect only. If you don't like them, I recommend that you start your own podcast about Star Wars Galaxies.
With?
Produce 50 episodes.
Yes.
And try to make things funny after all those times. And then you can complain about our bits.
Thank you for saying that. Because we're going to get into that eventually. But, brother, this one is about us.
Yeah.
We're not going to hold back. We're not. Today we're not from Minnesota, are we?
No, we're from... where would they be really rude? I don't know.
Oh, let's insult the whole state.
No,
here.
Let's not insult the whole state. How about a country instead?
Oh, insult the country.
How about we just avoid that?
Let's insult a Star Wars place. Yeah. Today we're from Loka.
No, not...
The galaxy. Loka galaxy.
Well, we have some Loka people we're going to...
I know,
play
but overall,
from.
You know...
Okay, overall in the forms... The local forums, let's say.
All right.
Okay. Back on the task, though.
Right.
Only then do you have the privilege of telling us that you just think we suck.
Oh, right. Yes.
Or any other day of the week,
the
really.
The ability to tell us that you suck must be earned.
Yes, must be earned.
Must be earned.
Yes. You must go in the little cave first and face your fears.
Like,
and...
earn this we have. Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
And, by the way,
what?
The views presented on our show are solely those of the creators... You and me, Mr.
Yay,
Bubble and Yivvits.
It's all about us.
It's all about us.
And my cat lawyer.
And your cat lawyer.
Meow.
I'm looking over your reports here. Meow. I'm not sure this is a good idea.
I need more Pounce.
Okay, here's more Pounce. Now how's the report look?
Uh-huh.
Oh, right. Mr. Bubble, 50 episodes.
Oh, my God.
I can't believe it, really. You know, that... Especially you and I being that committed to something.
That's a good point.
It's hard enough to get to work on time.
Yeah, I know. Because of this, actually.
Well, sometimes.
You gotta admit, when we started this, maybe we'll get to this later, but if we look at what we're doing now, like for this one or 49,
right.
If we sat down and said, okay, do you want to do this every week? No.
Oh, boy.
I think
but it grew into it.
Yeah, we kind of walked into it. That's a good point. And maybe we'll cover that in our little history segment.
The history of the podcast.
Yes. I'm trying to think. We have Roger Mudd coming out here. He's a History Channel guy.
Alan Alda could be the voiceover.
Alan Alda.
Patrick Stewart.
There,
that would work.
All right.
Mr. Bubble was once just a young cellist.
I saw everything.
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 Oh, but, you know, we've come a long way.
Yes.
We really have.
Yes, we have.
I think I'd like to start, if we could, by...
Yes.
We're not going to really... This isn't going to be like our usual show.
Oh,
which
yeah,
really,
good point. Tell me
that. Which really has no structure anyway.
No, but if there was any...
But if there was a structure...
Yeah.
We have, you know, a few bits and a few things, and then we'll do this and that. Mm-hmm.
We have a sing-along.
Yeah, a sing-along, mm-hmm. And we, you know, sing Kumbaya.
Mm-hmm.
But this week, we're going to sing Kumbaya, but not, you know, we'll do it later.
Mm-hmm.
And we want
the microphones
kind of
are off.
Could turn them off now. I'd like to sing it.
I'll pause and come back after Kumbaya.
Like,
there's off now. Oh, there you go. That was good.
Okay, good.
I feel much better.
This is going to just stand by itself. It's going to be an episode you can listen to if you're not sure our show or what it is. It's like that episode on a sitcom when they go back and rehash everything.
It's not that bad, though.
Okay, it's not that bad.
Because that's horrible. Those are like the writers don't want to work kind of weeks.
We've worked probably a total of, I don't know, 4 or 5 days on this now.
It's really sad, but yeah.
Because our show actually has a lot of production stuff in the background.
It's all about us.
Yeah.
This one.
We are definitely about production and quality. Mm. We're not a, you know, we're not
and
like
the ladies.
A live call-in show or something.
Right.
So it's a little bit more, it's a different, you know, I mean,
yeah,
with a live show, you have one take and that's it.
Right.
So sure, that's probably pretty difficult.
It's like
you spend a lot of time.
It's like opera. You know, the guys stand up on stage and belt it out, and there you go.
Exactly.
Compared to Pink Floyd, Dark Side of the Moon, heavily produced. Right.
Yeah.
Just like that.
Right. Okay. Just like that.
We're pretty. We're closer to Dark Side of the Moon than Pavarotti in the early 70s.
Yeah.
Not early 80s.
You're losing
late,
me. Okay. You're losing all me right. there. Pavarotti.
Yeah.
Pink Floyd. How do those
things
connect?
That start with P? Ready, go.
Pavarotti.
Piano. This thing has 88 keys and Summer White and Summer Black.
Pilo Do.
Next.
Philo
Do. Pass. this is not the color blue, but the color.
Pass.
Oh.
So anyway,
where you eat your lunch? The
table.
Oh.
Pink. But what? Piano.
The answer we're looking for is park.
Oh.
Remember, it's things that start with P. Park. Things that start with P.
Things you do with your car when you're going to stop it and put it somewhere.
I don't know.
Parallel drive.
This is stupid.
www.swgpodcast.com. You can go there and download most of our episodes. Mm-hmm. We're working on getting them all there. Mm-hmm. And you can even listen to some of the very early ones.
Yeah, you can start with our second one.
Yes. And today, we're going to have some clips from our first one, which is hideous.
Well, quality-wise.
Quality-wise, it's just terrible.
I was thinking about that. That doesn't matter. It's the content which is historic.
Well, and there's some very interesting points we'll bring up.
Right.
And we're not going to rail a lot on rants and gameplay
today. Here's the thing that's embarrassing, though. Because I have some recordings that are just crappy. You know, they're before whatever. And, like my Stanley Brothers. I was just listening, you know, you always give me crap on the Stanley. Ralph Stanley.
Sure.
Okay. I was just listening to those the other day, and there's like a lot of hiss and crackle and pop. But it's the Stanley Brothers, and it's great. And you could make the same argument with us, except we recorded our first one in 2005.
I was just going to say, that doesn't really seem to apply, but, you know.
If they did an album today like that.
Yeah, would be bad.
That'd be horrible.
So, go to www.swgpodcast.com or www.yivvitsandmrbubble.com for our forms.
Yep, or if you don't have a computer.
You can use your typewriter.
Yeah.
You can write us a letter, and then you can email it. Scan it and email it. Oh, wait.
Yeah, take it to a, bring it to a friend who has email.
Bring it to, like, an Instaprints or a Kinko's.
And walk in. Get your grandpa to walk in or something with a cane.
Oh, yeah. That'd be good.
Could you type this up for me?
Send it to Yivvits.
I'd like to dictate a letter for you. Can you type it?
And you can call our number, Mr. Bubble.
651-314-4357, 24 hours a day.
314-HELP.
Yep, 651-314-HELP.
You know, I think, let's start out with playing just a little montage of people who have called to thank us.
All right.
And just to congratulate us.
All right.
And we really appreciate it. And here you go.
That's cool.
Hey guys, this is Airdo from the Flurry and now Valve from Galaxy. Just wanted to say, guys, happy 50th episode. Time to get back to trivia, guys. We've been waiting for that. And always live under this quote. It's better to be rebel and thought a fool than go imperial and remove all doubt.
Hi, this is Y from Valson saying congratulations on episode 50. And we are looking forward to hearing a lot more in the future. Well done, guys.
This is Swiftgren from the Dolphin Galaxy. Congratulations to Yivvits and MrBubble on the occasion of their 50th podcast.
Hey, guys. This is Vladen Strozik / Urbane from the Dolphin Galaxy. I just want to say congratulations on your episode 50.
Greetings. This is Dak from Eclipse. And congratulations on episode 50, guys. It's a great show.
Hey, this is Akazu from the Narrative Galaxy. I just wanted to call and congratulate you guys on episode 50. And good luck, and thanks for the great show. And I'll see you on the 29th. Thanks a lot. Bye.
Hi, this is Alec from Valson. Just calling to wish you guys congratulations on episode 50. Talk to you later.
Hey guys, this is Datho from Bellison. Just wanted to wish you congrats on making it through 50 episodes.
What a nice
thing. Thanks, everyone. Swiftwind again for helping out with all of our parties and taking wonderful screenshots of those.
Yeah. Seriously, Swiftwind.
And,
thanks, man.
And helping out with our forums a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
It's really appreciated. And also our trivia champ, Dak. was in there. So congratulations.
And the first guy, the first customer. First
customer.
That's horrible.
You're still at work.
I am. The first person mentioned trivia. Maybe we'll bring it back. That's kind of how we do bits.
Yeah, I mean, we just...
Remember, it's all about us today. Yeah. When we feel it's right.
When I feel it's right. Right. And when you feel... No, you didn't let me finish.
Okay.
When I feel it's right.
Right.
And when you agree and feel it's right,
ah,
then, and only then, will we bring back something.
That's true. You gotta admit, in this whole thing, it's kind of like, it's taught us how to...
how to, like, actually make a podcast?
Yeah, no. Work relationships. You know, especially with people you know, it's hard. You gotta admit, it's hard. You know, we realize that. And...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it
especially
is.
Working with you.
Well, because we're both... We're both pretty much, like, monk, you know?
We can be, yeah.
We can be, totally.
We have certain things that trigger the monk... gene
instinct.
Or whatever that is. Right. Spent 3 hours tweaking one little thing. But that's good. The results show for that sometimes. Remember? That
yes.
This is all about us. Remember?
Okay. Yes.
But.
Patent backs.
One of, right. Back patent.
Good job, Mr. Bubble.
Heck of a job. Heck of a job,
heck
Brownie.
Of a job, Mr. Bubble.
Yeah. But, like, in our little things, like, should we do this or that? Usually we both have to be on board. Sometimes one of us will say, no,
you're different. Nope. We're doing it.
That kind of thing. But, you know,
or no, we're not. It just depends on what time it is,
right.
and all sorts of good things
all
like
right.
that. So,
moving on. Those are such sweet people. That's
well, yes.
great.
Thanks a lot. Moving on. You know, it'd be fun to give them a little history of the show.
Oh,
Now, we kind of covered this maybe an episode or two ago, and in the past we've said it too. But, you know, just in case people, you know, never listen to our show again or they have never listened before.
And I think that's a fair statement. I think a lot of people will not listen again after
I'm
today.
Sure. They'll be like, oh, 50, that means they're done, right? Yeah, you wish.
Yeah. Oh.
Only in your dreams.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Tell them.
What?
You start the story.
In the beginning.
In the beginning, there was Mr. Bubble.
Well, in the beginning, you played the game first.
Yes.
Because I did not play.
Because I was cooler.
Well, you were very... I was playing another game. I was playing There, T-H-E-R-E, There.com. A very masculine, very rugged, very aggressive, manly game. Oh, wait.
No, it's not. But it's a social game.
It's a social game. Very social. And I really had
it's a very social
met
game.
Some super nice people. Love that game. Great game. Because you could try on clothes.
Oh.
And you could stand in a group and talk about the clothes
that
you're trying on.
That outfit is lovely. Gosh, that's a good looking shirt
beaches.
On you.
It's still out there. If you go to there.com, T-H-E-R-E.com, and you could have a dune buggy, Yivvits.
Oh.
And you could hop in the dune buggy and drive around.
And
you could have jetpacks. And it wasn't like 80 million credits to get one. You could have a jetpack. And it was kind of cool.
But it wasn't Star Wars.
No, it wasn't. It wasn't like Boba Fett's jetpack. And you leveled up for things. You know,
like what? Card playing level 2?
Well, there is that.
Oh my gosh, I just looted a poker plus 3 attachment.
Right. The thing is, I didn't really understand leveling up was just for status because they would show it on your profile.
Oh.
It didn't give you any abilities.
Didn't do it. Okay.
Right. And I remember when the first time I played Star Wars, one of the first things I did is outside of a Bestine or wherever, I just walked in the hills and kept walking and walking and walking, just exploring the hills. And it was night on Bestine, and I died.
Uh-huh.
And I could not believe that. And I had to go home and rethink my life. No, I had to, like the death stick guy, I had to think. It makes total sense.
Mm-hmm.
Nighttime, outside Bestine, the hills, no weapons, you're going
to
die.
But, you know, it was possible to avoid that a lot of times. And back in those days, things didn't always kill you.
No.
You know.
And I probably touched some things or whatever.
Yeah, you probably, oh, what's this?
Mm-hmm. What's
this? What's this little thing?
And that's the way it should be. I don't have a problem with that. It should be that way.
Nice lizard. Nice lizard.
So, but no, that's what I did before. You did this. I followed Star Wars a long time.
Yes.
There was no space component. I thought that was not cool.
Mm-hmm.
So I waited for that, and I did start the day it officially came out in space.
You did.
I recall it being around Halloween of 2004.
Yeah, it was somewhere in the fall.
Around there. Because I remember playing the game with trick-or-treaters. I'm like, no. Get away from my house. Turn off the light, wife. But anyway, that was funny. Yeah, okay, so I did that, and you were already like, you should play.
Yeah,
it's fun.
Yeah.
It's fun crafting. You should play. No, okay.
Yeah. I knew you were in it for space.
We'll be nice. This is all. I'm sorry. I, that's my fault.
Hey, you better be.
I'm bad.
You better be.
I'm very bad. All right. So, yeah, then we play for a while, and then it becomes summer, spring, summer. Mm-hmm. Sun goes up, sun goes down.
Yeah. Many moons rotate over.
Right.
And all that time, we both kind of degenerated into some other subspecies of human.
You're right.
That,
but we're both nerds
that
at heart.
Games.
Nerds at heart.
Yeah.
We both love that. And then following the biz, you know, podcasts start to make it big on the scene.
Right.
I learned that Apple was including podcasts in iTunes.
Yes.
And that was going to be huge, because as you know, Apple always does things right and makes it... I'm just sorry. I'm pushing your buttons. I apologize again.
You're trying
I'm,
to
bad. I'm bad.
Using trigger words.
I'm very, very bad.
Trigger words.
Okay, so we knew iTunes was coming out with it. And podcasts were kind of the thing. And then I was they had like some focus stories on news that they'd have like eclectic little podcasts like, these two ladies are talking about child raising or something. And they have, you know, 500 listeners. And, and they play clips and it's just like, well, Marge, I always say that. You know?
You can be about anything. I mean, that was
right.
Neat about it. But
we heard a Star Wars Galaxies related one was starting up. And it's
you
the one
did. I didn't. This
is
all unbeknownst to me.
So I at our one of our lunches, our power lunches in town, Taco John.
Yeah,
it's like yeah, but let's try a podcast, that kind of thing. Yeah, kitchen table, blah blah blah, that kind of stuff. It worked out.
It took some convincing for me.
Yeah, just being on. It's kind of weird just talking into a microphone, isn't it?
Yeah,
you get used to it. But, yeah, it's okay.
I try to get used to it.
Yeah, the first time some things are awkward. Yeah, they just the first time you do some things in life, it gets better and better after that.
Lilith has been a bad, bad girl.
Right,
Lilith. Lilith,
bad girl. That's a new sound effect. Can I hear that?
That's a new sound effect. Oh no,
I don't
know where
to use
it.
That's great though. I love it.
I'll
sound
put it in again.
It's fun.
Sound effect.
We had no.
I told you to forget it.
Okay, all right. So we sat up at the table. We did not have sound effects the first time. We just talked. Maybe later in the show we can play some.
We're going to play some bits from it.
Yep. Maybe at the end of this rant we could talk about it.
Sure, why not?
Yeah. Anyway, it got done. It was only like 24 minutes long. Crappy audio. I messed up some little switch because I had the same sound as I used when
we're noobs.
We had the equipment though, or I had the equipment for my little church, little gospel band thing.
Yeah,
so the mixer and all that stuff. So we had the microphones. Blah 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 blah. Kitchen, and when we're done, it felt good. We had some laughs.
Yeah, it was funny.
Yeah, and it kind of
fueled
something in us.
We didn't know what we were doing, right? I mean, I didn't know where the whole thing was. What was the point?
Right.
You know?
And then we put it out there and published it and figured out how people can download all that stuff. And got it, you know, the syndication, all that stuff.
Yep.
And I remember the first week saying to myself, and I think to you, if we get 12 people to download, that'd be great.
Yeah.
And we did. It was like 12 people.
Yeah.
And a lot of them were not our family.
At least one or two.
But I did send to a couple friends and then my dad or something. And you notice that, you know, they were from that IP address. Like, I don't know. That doesn't really count, you know. It's kind of like in music when you have your family attend. What are they going to say?
That sucked.
Mr. Bubble, that was
so
horrible.
Bad.
You were out of tune.
Your levels were all
God,
wrong.
You need to practice more.
Actually, you know, knowing your family, I think your dad would maybe tell you that.
Nah,
I mean,
they're pretty fair.
That's good.
They're pretty fair. Yeah.
They'd be honest.
Good point.
Be honest.
Yeah. Your mom, though, she would.
Well, she's... She's a saint, though.
All right, so yeah, we got that. It felt good. And then, thinking about it, I asked you the question of your life. Will you commit to 6 more?
And I said, no.
Hell no?
No, I said yes.
And I said, if you don't, I'm going to release those JPEGs that you don't want me to release. No. No, and you did. We did 6. And by about episode 3 or 4, we were getting a lot more hits. Did we have in the hundreds yet? I can't remember.
Oh, I don't know. We want to give these things away.
Well, just ballpark figures. We had, by episodes 3 or 4 or 5, or whatever it was, it was ramping up.
It was like, we were excited to get like 40
right.
in a day or
That's
something.
Right. Yeah, and by that I mean
which
a day,
were well, even then, I don't know if we ever really got 40 in a day.
Well, it was, point is it
was more.
Wait, yeah. So anyway, at the end of 4, 5, or 6, some people were saying, please don't stop after 6. And
so,
that's when it started to fuel our egos.
Yeah, because, you know, we're from Minnesota, and
it was fun, though.
You know, we just kind of, we don't want to, you know, put anyone out.
Personally, I mean, my sense, it gave...
My sense?
It just gave me...
No.
Me's a feeling okie day.
Oh, podcast going really okie
no,
day
but
good.
You got to admit, it helped... It gave a different reason to play the game and to keep up on things.
True.
I mean, and to stay in it and stay socially connected and learn new things and just explore and follow the
right.
whole thing and get feedback from people. And that was just unexpected.
Yeah.
And very fun.
We didn't set out to be a news source.
God, no.
For the game.
No. No. Great point. Right.
And we wanted to just more or less, you know, talk about what we did in the game. It's
right.
like our intro.
It's like,
it's like we just talk about what we did the last week. You know, which is probably kind of odd, but that's what we do.
Yeah.
And
you don't have to listen.
Yeah, don't have to listen. You can start your own up and do 50, like I said. Then you can say something about it.
You do 48, you still can't complain.
Nope, not till 50. Nope. way.
No, but there are other podcasts that do focus on the news, and that's excellent. I'm glad they're, because then we don't have to as much.
And we have dedicated some episodes more or less to covering major issues, and we do cover some news each week, but it's not the main focus. We're not here to read the published notes out to you.
But
sometimes we do.
Some things are huge.
Yeah.
And my role is usually to throttle you back a bit, because you really care deeply about this stuff. Way more than I do. No, but... yeah. But, So we have some fun with it. And so that kind of kicked in, then it just went in, let's keep rolling, because what did we say? As long as we're having fun, have something to talk about...
Yeah, we'll just keep doing it.
There you go.
Yeah. Some weeks we're busy, and sometimes
here we are.
It doesn't seem like it turns out, but then it always does.
No, some days I just wake up the day of the recording. You got to admit, you do this too. I'm like, what the heck are we going to do today?
I know.
And then it turns out to be an hour and a half of just gabbing. It's kind of funny. So.
And if it's funny to somebody else, then hey, you know.
Yeah.
But even if it's not, hey, you know.
Yeah, right. All right.
So, well.
What do you got to add? Anything to add? What's your perspective of the whole thing, friend? What do you.
You know, well, you started it.
Put it in terms of you. No, well, put it in terms of you. Like, I ask you and then what?
I've never been the type of person to do this kind of thing, you know.
I do them all the time, but.
Well, I know you have like 5 podcasts.
Right, right.
But
most of them I can't mention.
But I started. Yeah, I'm sure about that. It's just starting to get fun. And I just kind of said, you know, let's just make it about having fun, talking about the game and our friends in the game. And we started talking to people.
But
and
more interestingly, how did it affect you and your desire to play and socially and that kind of thing?
So I didn't, you know, I did more, well, I don't know. You know, it really doesn't affect other than the fact that I, you know, do the parties and stuff. And I never used to go to that kind of stuff.
Yeah. Right.
You know, I still don't make it go out of my way to go to other things, and that's just me. I'm kind of an introvert
That's okay. That's fine.
But it's a lot of fun, and you know, I haven't been playing as much, and that's probably good. You know, you don't want to hit it too hard for many years straight, because you'll end up, you know, having nothing else.
Well.
But this keeps me focused in it when I do log in there, and I do try to get in, you know, many times a week if I can. But, you know, lately, obviously, it's been a little bit crazy with this show, 50th episode and stuff.
Yeah, it seems like the last 3 or 4 weeks, this show's been taking more and more hours, which is a good thing for the result, but...
Right.
Yeah.
So,
It ends now.
Cool. It ends now. No, so, you know, we just kind of were getting towards the 50, and we're like, hey, let's just keep pumping it out like we are, and then we'll figure out how we're going to change it if we have to.
Right.
Afterwards. It changes for the good, not... This isn't the NGE kind of
Oh, we'll get to
change.
That. We have a segment for that.
Yeah.
One quick question, Yivvits.
What?
This is a delicious-looking cake. I want to cut the cake now. Can we cut the cake?
No. Cannot cut the cake.
Can you describe the cake? Or we'll get to that part.
We'll have a picture of it on the forum.
This is a nice cake, though.
There is a cake here, by the way.
It's a vanilla sheet cake.
It has buttercream frosting. as the Emperor confirmed.
From the bakery.
From the bakery, and it has a picture of Vader.
I felt like a tool ordering it and picking it
Yoda.
Up, I'll tell you that, yeah.
Yeah, that's quite funny.
I asked, yeah, because we'll talk about that.
Oh, is your son having a birthday?
I know. It's like, do you have anything Star Wars related? The lady's like, we might have to look in the back room. It's like, can you do that? And then trying to spell out Yivvits and MrBubble.
Who are you? Who are the Yivvits and
exactly.
MrBubble?
Exactly. What's a podcast?
Cannot have the cake yet.
Right.
Yep.
I told you to forget it.
All right. No cake, but it looks good.
Well, I'm sure it is good.
Buttercream frosting.
I'm sure it is good. Tell you. You know, the Emperor was really concerned about that.
Oh, yeah. Well, he's got his... Yeah, he's got his things.
It's buttercream.
All right, so what's next? Well, that's interesting what you say about the parties. Yeah.
Yeah, well, I know. Let's play another little group of callers.
Okay.
We had a lot of callers. And
let's get them rolling. Get them rolling.
Let's play that.
Hi, it's Once from Valfin saying congrats on your 50th episode.
Hey, it's Afterburner from Valson. Congratulations on 50 episodes, and here's 50 more.
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Atiers from Corbontis, and I was just calling to say congrats on 50 episodes. And so now I have a little joke for you. So there are these three huts in an airplane, and they decide to jump out of the airplane. Two land on land, and one lands in the water. Boom!
Hey, this is Obi-Wan Kenobi from the Valson Galaxy. Congratulations, Yivvits and MrBubble, on podcast 50. Y'all come a long way. and the show's gotten better and better every single week, and I enjoy listening to it along with a lot of other people. So, later.
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Abel Spiegel from Kettermore. Just calling in to congratulate you guys on your 50th episode. I actually quit Star Wars Galaxies about 3 months ago, but I still listen to you guys. All right, take it easy.
This is Lumet from the Velcan Galaxy. Congratulations on your 50th podcast.
Nice.
Thanks, guys.
I always like hearing from
people. Obi-Van, thanks.
Obi-Van.
He was on our show a couple times.
Good friend of the show, yeah.
You know, I appreciate the call, but I don't quite understand that joke.
Ugh. That Jabba joke?
What am I missing?
I don't know. You might have to rewind it again. I know. I
mean, you need to call us back and let us know.
It sounds like a variation of a lawyer joke that's just...
I think so.
That the joke is that three Hutts die, and that itself is funny. I mean, that's the only way I interpret it.
I suppose that could be funny.
Yeah.
Rather messy.
Because if you convert that to lawyers, okay, I'm still not saying it's funny, but it's the way a lot of lawyer jokes are. They don't make sense.
The punchline is that they die.
Lawyers are dead. Right.
Right.
Exactly.
Okay.
So I'm hoping that's the interpretation. Otherwise, that joke sucks.
But we do thank you for calling.
Of course.
It does mean a lot to us.
And the first one in there, Once, how sweet is she?
Oh, Once.
Yeah, she's a little female Celestine on the galaxy.
One of the very few.
One of the very few. Yep. Just very cute. So thank you for calling.
Yep.
I like
she
the
always
accent.
Comes with Y.
Love the accent.
Doesn't she always come with Y?
I don't know.
Are they?
I don't know.
I don't remember.
I don't
Once
know.
And Y? They're two Solas.
It's cute. Those are cute names.
Once and Y. Once, Y,
and MrBubble.
You know.
Yes.
I think it's time that we probably eat some of that cake.
Are you kidding me?
I think we should.
You're not teasing me now.
No, I don't. No, I don't think we should.
Is it time on our agenda? Are you serious? It's time to cut the cake?
It's on the agenda.
Let's see. History of the podcast.
See, I didn't want to hold it out too long because I want some cake too.
But you forgot looking back episode one.
Oh, I did?
Mm-hmm. I like delayed. I'm into delayed gratification. You should know that about me. Yivvits.
I have to wait.
I know. Now you gotta wait for the cake, Wookie. All right, Rancor Keeper. Yeah.
Poor Rancor.
You know, because it said, looking back at episode one, play color group two, and then cut the cake.
All right.
So let's look back at episode one.
Let's do that.
This is living history.
Yeah.
It's actually.
I need to find it first.
It's really narcissistic, but it's okay because this is all about us today.
But see, we never released this one. So
that's true.
It's pretty tough to.
But it is history.
They're not going to get it.
It's historical because it is number one. It's the first thing on that kitchen table. It's the first podcast we recorded.
Yeah.
Awkward microphones, just awkward talking, hearing yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Everything was new. The
awkward
mixing, the publishing
it was you.
Yeah.
But,
right.
You know,
because we're both adults talking. We're both
talking about a video game.
Right.
What?
And that hasn't changed. That's still awkward. Yeah.
It's the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
I have to get this queued up here.
Okay, get it queued.
That's what I'm doing this moment.
This is exciting. And you'll hear why we haven't really been too eager to release it.
Believe us, you don't want to hear it.
Yeah, I mean.
Yeah.
It's
bad.
Yeah. Okay. Some switch was flipped. The mixer was kind of new to me back then. There's one tiny little switch that would have fixed everything.
It was weird. Mm-hmm. It was just not good. It was not a good.
That's how I learned things. I'm glad I'm not a doctor. Because that's the way
you had to cut some of this banter out.
That's fine. But that's the way I am in life with learning things is, you know, you mess up, then you learn from that. And
true.
If I was a surgeon, I'd be a bad surgeon. I'd be like, I'm sorry about your...
yes, you would be.
I'm sorry about your husband, man. But I learned a lot. I got to say. So it was good for me. It's a positive. The lemons into lemonade, let me tell you.
It was a learning experience.
Right. It was a very good learning experience.
Very good learning experience.
I need to fill out these forms. But yeah, it was a good learning experience.
Ma'am, can you fill out the forms?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you ready here?
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. Here's a blast from the past for you.
Episode
now, remember...
Uno. What?
This is... Episode one,
yeah.
over a year ago now.
July 7th, I think.
We didn't know what we were doing, so we'll comment on
the content's what's important.
Yeah. Hey, the music was still there.
Everything's the same. We like that theme song. We really
that we knew that right away.
Knew it totally. We knew that in 1998 or 7.
Yeah.
From that time you changed the answering machine at our store. That was great. Hold music.
At our store?
Yeah. Well, we used to work at the same place.
Oh, yeah. No, it's like not like we own a store.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, you want to open a store?
No.
Birdseed?
No.
Well, hey, welcome.
Oh.
This is Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and MrBubble.
Sounds terrible.
And I'm MrBubble.
It's history.
I'm Yivvits. Hey, Yivvits.
That's me.
What are you?
I'm a Wookiee.
You're a Wookiee.
I sound like
so
that?
Lame. I'm a Wookiee.
Shh. Let it soak in.
Kashyyyk.
Oh. Yes.
Kashyyyk. No, Kashyyyk.
Kashyyyk. Kashyyyk. I thought it was Kashyyyk.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, Yoda knows how to pronounce it. So.
And Mace knows how to say it.
Oh, that's true.
It's Kashyyyk, like Kashyyyk.
It's us, though,
like
dude.
Kashyyyk.
It is.
A little bit. Mm-hmm. Kashyyyk.
Yeah. Where are you from?
Sullust.
Yeah.
So am I a rookie, and I'm from Kashyyyk.
I know.
Or whatever it was.
I used to think it was Sullustian, but I'm a Sullustan, and I have a kind
of
sound different, so that's hard to...
Oh, yeah.
Sullustan. Yeah.
Well, and you like Lust.
We
so.
Put the Lust.
Whoa!
Right?
Whoa.
That's what our bumper stickers say back then.
No, it looked like a dog.
Okay.
But, you know, it got converted with the combat upgrade.
Oh, combat upgrade. You're still
it.
Bitter on that.
Now, this sounds familiar.
It's, I forgot the date. I gotta say the date right.
Oh, the date? Oh.
What is it?
Well, not the date, but...
Thursday,
July
7th.
Here's your history books.
2005.
If you were wondering.
Yes. Because, and so we're... We're currently on version 19.0.
Right? Of the game.
19.0.
And there's maybe a hidden decimal in there. I don't know.
I can't wait for 20. I'm excited.
Yeah, 20 is going to suck.
Why? What's 20 about?
Because they don't fix anything.
I don't know.
Ah. 20, they're going to do something with Jedis and bounty hunters.
Oh, wow.
Make it so bounty hunters can't gang up on Jedi, which, you know, is nice for them, but I really could care less.
Right now, we're waiting for more Jedi changes as well. Jedi and bounty hunter, yeah. And fix bugs. That's so funny. The more things change.
On a Jedi.
Right.
And,
as they should.
Well, yeah. That's one for the history books, Smed. Like
that's too funny. Yeah, if you're listening, Smed. He might be listening.
Maybe.
This
you
might
never
be
know.
Going.
Like,
he'd never call us.
Probably not.
He should call us sometime.
Yeah.
Pliffle. I just like saying his name.
Pliffle.
I like
Pliffle
engines. Is there anything like Poofy?
Pliffle.
Poofy? No. Pliffle.
It didn't take much to crack us up.
No. It still doesn't.
No, that's true.
Canary.
Oh,
Canaryville.
We know Canary.
God dang.
Do you ever bump into Canary?
He got mentioned on the first episode.
No, I don't.
What
I don't
a. That's going to make his head explode.
Oh, okay.
He's going to jack up his prices now.
Wow.
That sounds almost as fun as.
He could double his prices. As mentioned on Yivvits and MrBubble's first episode, double prices.
My apologies, Pliffle.
Anything else, Yivvits?
I have nothing else for you.
All right. MrBubble. Yivvits.
And Yivvits. And,
that was a short podcast.
Well, you know, but the thing is, I mean, it's just...
We edited a bunch out.
It's very hard to listen to because it's so...
Doesn't matter.
Oh, wait. Oh, we were in Tyrena, the cantina.
Nice.
I'll try a different cantina next time.
I remember that was a nice cantina.
Mm.
I don't know.
Yeah, they have really good blue milk.
Oh.
They don't serve that in there anymore now.
No. Shut down.
Bye-bye. Thanks for listening.
Bye-bye.
Thanks for listening.
I'm a geek. Thanks for listening.
Thanks for listening.
Bye. I like Star Wars Galaxy.
No, it was actually about 24 minutes long. We just edited some choice bits
we
there.
Just to show that, you know, the whole show is still kind of there in the same full, you know, manner, but it's just better.
The structure, yeah, and we learned. So after that, the next episode sounded better. And we've made our first six after that or so available, so you can tell the progression. And
they're not perfect.
No, of course.
But
we're just being monkey.
We're perfect now.
Yeah.
Oh,
but,
perfect.
But if you start listening to the old ones, I think we intend to keep those going, don't we? Until, until we get to the NGE.
We'll get them
part.
All up there, yeah.
That'll be funny.
Yeah. It just stands to go. All you have to do is listen to the things there. Mm-hmm. Published 19. We're still waiting for bug fixes. We're editing Jedi and Bounty Hunter, and that's what we're doing now.
Okay.
In the game. So, just an interesting point is all.
You know why I'm glad to be done with that, though?
Why?
Cake.
Let me think. Yes.
All right.
I didn't have to think much, did I?
We're going to pause it and get our cake.
Oh, good. Cake.
Well, we'll talk about it, but
cake time.
We'll be right back.
It's cake time, cake time, cake time for me. Podcast cake. Really, really good cake.
You like that?
Yum, yum. You know, this is either going to make people really sick or really hungry.
Or they think they're just the stupidest thing ever in the world. In the world.
They're eating cake on a podcast. Nom, 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 nom.
But it's good. Describe the cake.
Oh, the cake. This is a lovely cake from the Theed Bakery.
Culinary Institute.
Yes, the Theed Culinary Institute Bakery. It's, you know, the kids have to learn somewhere.
Oh, right.
So we're like, make us a cake. I'm like, okay, what do you want on it? We want Star Wars. Or we want Vader or something. Or Yoda.
Mm-hmm.
And it's white cake.
It's white cake.
Mm-hmm.
They had to go in the back room to find it. The pattern. No, it's got one of those digitized pictures or whatever of Vader on there. It's like a montage of Vader and Yoda. Mm-hmm. It's happy,
his frosting.
Buttercream.
Buttercream frosting.
Happy 50th.
It's very, very good.
It says, happy 50th podcast, Yivvits and MrBubble.
Mm. You know, I've heard that this bakery makes the highest rated buttercream frosting of any city.
The Malastarian Council agrees, or whatever.
MrBubble agrees. The Council from Malastare agrees.
MrBubble definitely agrees.
That means this cake's really good.
My second little corner piece. I like the unsheet cakes, little corner pieces.
Mm, yes. We're going to end up with half the podcast talking about the cake.
Probably.
So, what did they do on their 50th episode? Oh, they talked about a cake for a half an hour.
That's all right. That's all right. We earned this cake. We freaking earned, buddy.
Mm. Mm-hmm. Uncle Owen, do you like the cake?
Oh, that little crank.
I think he does, though.
Oh, is that his way of saying sure?
Jar Jar, do you like the cake?
Uh-huh.
Oh, see, now I knew Jar Jar would like it.
I knew it.
He's just...
Well, while we're eating this, do you have any other people that called in? I think you have some special people, right?
Well, let me see here. Oh, sure. How about this one?
Hey, check it. This be your main boy, Ali G.
Ali G.
I was calling with my main man, Giblet and Mr. Bubbles. A well good 50th episode for that show. Respect. I check it. I must be bouncing now. I got to catch Giblet's mother in East Compton. I
what?
I can't even stand it, but it sounds funny.
Ollie G, huh? He's a comedian.
Yeah, I'm glad he called in.
Yeah, I'm surprised we got a call from him. That's a pretty big deal. What are you doing now?
I don't have
you
any.
You got a mess over there.
I'm a Celestin. I guess my slobber everywhere. Do you have another call?
You get frosting stuck in the jowls.
One more good
call. All right. Just shut up. Yivvits, keep going. All right. How about this one?
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble.
Yes.
Time Bandit here. Feature Valsonite on Star Wars Galaxy.
Mm, Time Bandit. Future.
Just calling to say congratulations on upcoming episode 50.
Thank you.
And I want to give a shout out to my good buddy Obi-Van in real life. He told me to listen to you guys.
Obi-Van.
It was probably one of the greatest decisions of my life.
Really?
You guys are pretty much the only reason. One of the only reasons I'll be playing this game within the coming month. So,
I wanted
to call and say congratulations on episode 50.
Wow. Right,
guys. I gotta say, I don't agree with some of that, but one thing I do agree with.
What do you mean you don't agree with it?
Well, I do agree it is the greatest decision of his life.
Oh, exactly. Yeah.
No question there.
Well, of all time.
Is that what he said, of all time?
No, but I'm just saying. I mean, I'm gonna interpolate extrapolate.
I mean, as he goes down life's river and. And encounters various things. They might be graduating from school.
Some of us get a degree. Some get married. But some listen to our show.
Right. And to him, and his journey down the river, good for him.
Yeah. No, thanks a lot, actually.
That's so sweet. Thank you.
And we hope to see you there on Valsin. Good old Valsin.
Yep.
Come to a party.
Definitely.
Hang out.
Yep.
One more?
Sure. One more.
All right.
Hey, boys. It's Lilith.
Lilith.
Happy 50th.
Our first female caller.
Can you just connect us without me? So I hope you guys have a good one. And we'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
Oh, thanks, nice. Lola. That's right. She was the first female caller.
She was our first female caller. And our second, along
since
with
you're talking
along
about female
with
callers,
Lola Jenny.
Let's get that one more out of the way. I know there's that other female caller.
Oh, that one.
Yeah. While I'm in a good mood with the cake.
Hi, all you Star Wars fans. This is MrBubble's ex-wife, and I'm calling to say that Star Wars Galaxies was not the reason we split. Oh. The reason we split is because...
What?
I think you might have missed something there.
Yeah, it's funny. Sometimes the voicemail thing doesn't get everything. That was my ex-wife, though. How about that?
It was your ex-wife.
Even she called in.
But I'm still... I'm really curious to... know what the purpose was,
we'll
what the reason
know.
Was.
You never know.
Hmm.
But there you go.
That's suspicious. That's very suspicious. I don't know, MrBubble.
Oh, well. Even ex-wives calling. How important we are. Remember, it's all about us.
It's all about us.
They can't not call. People calling.
No, they're like, we got a call. Yeah. I got a call.
Usually they're the ones we didn't play.
Yeah. Woohoo! I don't know about that.
Alright. We're still
let me finish it right here.
You
want to pause or
No,
I don't want them to hear my smack.
Eat. Yum.
Cake was good.
We really got a lot of mileage out of that cake. I love that.
Yeah, we might have to trim that down.
I think
maybe
so.
Maybe not, but maybe.
Who cares? We got cake.
That's a recurring bit in our show. We always gonna trim things out.
Right, and it's always inflates it or whatever. Yeah.
Yeah. So oh, we well. Just always say.
Yeah, whatever.
Sometimes it happens, sometimes it isn't. You know, okay, so we got these sound effects, right?
All right. Yes, we do.
You know, and we try not to overuse them. Some days we do.
Like every day.
Some,
yeah.
Some, day we, some days we do. Because it's just so funny. Right. You know? Like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, that's a good one. I
Jar Jar is good.
Can never have enough of that.
Let's
one.
Play a few of them. How about it?
Okay.
You know, we got the other Jar Jar.
Right.
We got the.
Uh huh.
Uh huh.
Very good.
Jar Jar. Was the cake really, really good?
Uh-huh.
Do you want another piece?
He's had too much. That's a sugar rush.
it's a like, sugar rush.
Jar Jar, are you having a sugar rush?
Jar Jar, you calm down. You are hyperactive now. and of course we've got, you know, Uncle Owen. He's being Mr. Grumpy. You
yeah.
Know,
just, now, now, we started doing him when he... The actor passed away. Mm. And we got some good things. And they just kind of stuck.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That's him around the dinner table with Luke and those guys. It's in the movie.
He's so cranky.
He is.
He's such a cranky
eating
old
little
man.
His little porridge.
And
blue milk.
And there's another Uncle Owen one.
Mm-hmm.
And we thought it would be maybe a neat occasion, mm-hmm. but very sad for many listeners.
Right.
If we retired a sound effect.
Retired? Oh, my.
Retired.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
It's back in the vault.
Oh, dear. Yep, for at least a week or something.
Yeah.
But just, you know, today we're not going to retire it like now, but this will be the last episode.
For hearing which one?
For hearing.
I told you to forget it.
Oh.
Yeah.
That one's so useful, too.
It is useful.
Because you use it today to shut me up a few times about, you know, that's yeah. always.
I told you to forget
yeah,
it.
Yeah, like,
just let it go. It's going to happen,
exactly.
Mr. Bubble. It's going to happen. All right?
Uh-huh.
I quit if you get rid of that Jar Jar one. You can't get rid of uh-huh.
Oh, I will not uh-huh. do that.
Because it cracks me up.
It is classic.
It is.
Classic.
And that's from where again?
Classic George.
Is that...
Oh, this? This is, what, this sound effect?
The uh-huh.
Yeah, well, these... Well, I'm not going to give it away. They'll have to go and get
okay.
it themselves.
No, it's from... I know what it is now. I know
Phantom
what it
Menace.
Is.
He's in the ship, talking to Padme.
Padme says, are you a Gungan?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
Are you an idiot?
Uh-huh.
You could ask him anything.
You could.
it's perfect.
but no more. I
no
told
more.
You to forget it.
I told you to forget it.
Okay.
No.
Well, if you hear that, this will be the last time for a long time.
Yes.
A
so tell us if there's any other. You know, it, mm-hmm. not that we'll use it because we're very self-controlling, or I don't know how you want to say it, of our show.
Yeah.
You know, we
protective.
We like protective.
The
we,
franchise, like Lucas and his franchise.
Yeah. Which. By the way, we have nothing to do with Lucas.
Like the Mr. Bubble and Yivvits franchise.
Exactly. Yeah. And you know, if there's something, like a quote you think is kind of funny,
mm-hmm.
well, let us know. We maybe, if, but we're probably not saying we will.
No.
But it's always fun to
actually, we're probably saying we won't.
Okay, forget it then. Yeah, forget it. Sorry.
Don't do it.
But that's just us.
Use it on your own podcast.
We're just like that. Yep. Oh, yeah. Only until you get to episode 50.
Then.
It's kind of like leveling. It's podcast
oh,
leveling.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
when
yeah.
we first started, we were noobs.
Oh, very good.
All right. This nice. Is a good analogy.
This is an excellent analogy.
But unlike Star Wars Galaxies, we actually fixed our bugs.
Right. Oh, excellent. And listen to feedback.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
We have listened to feedback.
Nice. Great analogy. Otherwise, yeah. Hear that, Smed?
Oh, yeah. He's not listening.
He's
listening
never
to the show.
Listening.
Yeah, right. He hates us.
He hates you more, but yeah, he hates us.
Yeah, yeah, I'm sure. You know, you have a conversation with him every week.
Oh, we
at
do
Starbucks.
Lunch. We do lunch. Yeah, Starbucks. Oh, okay, a frappuccino.
Yeah, I'd like a frappuccino.
One for my pal, Mr. Bubble, too.
Say, Chris, Kyle, what would you like?
I want a frappuccino.
Yes, make that two. Two frappuccinos.
Yeah, there you go.
I'd like a caramel macchiato.
We say it in jest, though.
Yeah. Now, would he say espresso or would he say espresso? Like, it drives me nuts.
No, I think he'd say it right.
I think he would.
I'd
too.
Say I think he would because he knows it's caffeine.
I had a friend who was just that was her
espresso.
That was her. No. That's her picky thing about judging character. If she hears someone say espresso, it's like I'm done with that person. I know I can't get along with them. Anyway,
back to the podcast
right.
leveling.
All right.
That's a good analogy. I just came up with it.
Mm, yeah, excellent.
You know, we have a... Thank you.
Well done, Yivvits.
Well done, Lord Vader. Is the song ready?
You've done well, my friend.
You've done well.
Yeah.
You've done well with the singers.
The Imperial singers.
No, so you start out, and you're new, and then
right.
you once you get to, like, level 5... But it's a skill-based system.
Mm,
it's not a level-based
abilities
system.
Open up, right.
Yeah, it's a skill-based system, like the pre-NGE, or
nice,
pre-combat upgrade.
Nice.
And we were able to, at that point, look in our skill tree and see that it included use second laptop. And then that's
all. There are two of them.
That's like level 5.
Right.
Another two of them. Mm-hmm. And what? Level 10,
yeah,
we got pop filters.
That was huge.
Yeah. It set it right in the skill tree, so you knew exactly what it gave you.
Right, right. You're just hoping for level 10. You're just hoping to get
it.
In
that place, there was a picture in that part of the skill wheel. There was a picture of a pop filter.
Yeah, and again, we've rambled before, but if this is your first episode, those are those things in front of the microphones that make it so when you say pop, 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 it doesn't make your ears explode on headphones. It
doesn't go boosh, pop, pop, pop.
Yeah, right.
Well, ow, that hurt, actually.
I know, isn't that amazing?
It is a sudden rush of air.
And the first ones were your mom's pantyhose.
Yes, they were.
Yeah.
We've mentioned that quite often.
And the funny thing is, after I bought professional ones, you still prefer your mom's pantyhose pop filters. That's fine. It's America. You can do that.
I told you to forget it.
You're gonna miss that one.
I have to use it on you.
That's going to make you lonesome.
I'll find something better, believe me. I'll find a 3PO one to replace that.
Oh, yes.
Oh.
There are
so
many 3PO ones.
Oh, dear. Oh,
I have decided that we shall stay here.
I have decided. Oh, curse my second. I was too slow.
Oh, this oil bath is going to feel
wonderful.
But
when you get to level 50 of your podcast,
mm-hmm.
When you move. You get the MIDI keyboard.
Yeah, your toy.
Skill box.
Your toy.
That's like the master skill box.
You're just purring like a cat right now with this toy. I love it. I love seeing Yivvits excited.
Yeah.
I do. It's cool. It's super cool.
Yeah. Yeah.
Plug it. What is it?
It's a what do you want to call it?
It's cool.
It's a droid. No, it's just a little keyboard. We got sound effects on there. We don't want to spoil all the secrets.
No, but right. But
it's all of our secrets. We can't give them away.
It's part of the plan. Part of the skill tree.
When we get to level 100,
oh.
that's when you are probably checked into a mental institute.
Definitely.
So what's next here? I kind of sidetracked us there a little bit.
I think we had cake.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's time for presents.
How about first we play another montage of callers?
Okay, while we get our presents.
Okay.
There you go.
Yeah, I know. It sounds really stupid. We got presents. But remember, we had presents for our Christmas episode,
too. It's all about us. Remember, don't worry about it.
Exactly.
I don't care if nobody's listening. Brother, we're not even going to publish this episode. How about that?
Okay.
It's just going to sit in my basement and talk.
It'll be in the vault forever. The lost episode. Yeah. Here's some more callers.
Okay, listen to these while we get our presents.
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Nodge from the Bria Galaxy. Congratulations on your 50th episode. You guys are awesome.
Congratulations on 50 episodes, Ryan.
Hey guys, it's Mr. Happy from Valson. Just wanted to congratulate you guys. Out.
Hi, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Mephic from the Valson Galaxy saying congratulations on your 50th podcast. Looking forward to more great work. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.
Hey guys, this is Adolphus from the Radiant Galaxy. I just wanted to congratulate you on your 50th show. Keep up the good rants. They are truly appreciated. Have a good day and enjoy your cake.
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Ekek Staya from the Local Galaxy. Just wanted to thank you guys for doing such a bang up job with the podcast. I've listened to you guys since like episode 11. Can't believe you're already up.
This is Rasita Vile from the Radiant Galaxy, pre-MGD Jedi Padawan, congratulating MrBubble on their 50th Star Wars Galaxy podcast. Keep up the good work with SWG the way it is. We need something to smile about. Thanks, guys. Bye.
I can't believe we're up to episode 50 either. I mean, I still can't believe it.
And I enjoyed my cake. That's
the
whoever
cake
said
it. Was delicious.
It all goes back to the cake.
Ah, Lord Vader.
And that Yoda.
Cake
Yoda
was
voice.
Wonderful.
That was Mr. Happy.
Mr. Happy.
That was good.
Mr. Happy. Yes, he came into the parties. I think that's, where did we first see him? At a party.
I believe so, yes.
Yeah. I think his name is an homage to you of some degree.
I think so. Yeah.
I think
it's
so.
It's just a cute name. It's funny.
Mr. Happy. He's Mr. Happy.
And he's a Celestine as
happy.
Well. So yeah,
he's great. A happy guy. So what do we got next here? This is
presents.
This is kind of the sad part, really. But it's,
yeah, because we're adults.
We're adults.
Again,
but,
in the basement of my house.
Yeah.
Good. Recording a Star Wars podcast about just eating
let's
cake.
Let's just not even talk about what it
and
what
about to exchange
like.
Presents.
Yeah.
Do you want my lame one first?
Well, since you wanted all the trouble.
Okay. Because we did this on our Christmas show. You gave me a great gift. It's still on my desk. You gave me a TIE bomber, die-cast TIE bomber.
Oh,
awesome.
That's right.
I still look at it. It's upstairs.
You still look at it,
I do. I still enjoy that. I still play with that when I'm waiting for a download or something.
Okay.
Yeah, this is what I got you.
I'm gonna sense what it is.
Okay.
Mm. I'm using the midichlorians.
Mm.
It's in a brown paper bag.
Yeah, as all good
very
gifts are.
Very stylish. Very stylish. And
that's
what
right.
do we have? We have... We have Unleashed Battle Packs. It is from the Battle of Kashyyyk.
That's right.
Well, thank you very much, Mr.
Now, what
Bubble.
Is it, though?
It is a set of action figures.
Yes.
Modeled after Wookiees.
There you go. See, because you're a Wookiee.
From Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith.
Right.
Which you can buy on DVD now.
Yes.
For. No, it's great. There's even things that are... They're even carrying weapons
mm-hmm.
that are in the game.
Primitive Wookiee weapons, but nevertheless.
They are, much more powerful than you could ever imagine.
They're pikemen, probably.
No, they're more powerful than
Those dudes in the package, what would they be, commando or what? What would they
be? I don't know what they are. They're Wookiees.
Okay. All right.
Let's see. What, does it say who they are?
Tarful.
It could be.
Could be.
Now, these are Unleashed things. They're kind of modeled more in action.
A little more detail, too, yeah.
Action-y.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I was looking for things. You know, because obviously we were going to exchange toys.
Of course.
You know, which is sad in itself. But.
I mean, if I gave you, like, the 7 habits of highly effectual people or something like that, that'd be a silly gift.
Thank you very much.
You'd say, oh, very good job.
Yeah. No, that's more or less like a gift you'd get from a public radio drive. You know? Signed by the author.
Right, right.
No, these are great. Thanks, Mr. Bubble.
When good things happen to bad people.
I saw these, and I knew that I should not get these for you.
Really?
Because first of all, you don't really like Wookiees
too
much.
I'm not into Wookiees, no. I hang out with a Wookiee long enough here.
Yeah, you always complain about the smell, which I don't believe
there
is. But
oh well. My cleaning...
It's the basement,
My cleaning lady's like, oh, this hair, good.
Now, mine is wrapped.
Okay, this will be good.
You know?
Yeah, like mine was wrapped, but in a brown paper bag. Okay.
Right.
All right.
Mine's just wrapped tighter.
Okay. Oh, it's...
There you go. I wrote your name. On it,
let's see. It says...
Mr.
Bubble.
It's hard to write. Wookiees are very difficult things to write.
Oh, my heavens. It's going to be big.
Well, you know, there's something there for... There's two things there.
I already like the first thing I see.
See, I found the one, but then there was something else that I had to have for our studio.
Ooh, now I know his name.
Well, no, there's something different about that guy.
Really?
Yes. Maybe you want to tell him what it is.
Oh, but man, okay. I am looking at a action figure from Revenge of the Sith. This is Lushros Dufine.
And he's a Nemodian.
Nemodian.
Oh!
Okay.
Get me out of this bubble packaging.
Now, which one is he? Is he one of the two
no,
that we mock?
It shows later in this. This is from Episode 3. And... He is the new commander of the ships.
Oh, okay.
He's not the same person.
Okay.
Help, I'm stuck in this bubble packaging.
Yeah, because it says...
Can you get me out? I'm suffocating in here.
Okay, I see.
See?
I got you. Yeah,
see?
yeah. He's the one on the ship that crashed in the beginning, right? Or no?
I don't know. But no.
I don't know. He's cute. No, I like that. I like that a lot. I like that. And this, what?
This is really funny. He's cute.
He's cute. Now.
I'm going to save that WAV file and use it.
This one, my friend, rocks.
Yeah, well.
Not that he didn't rock, but he's for comedy.
He's for comedy.
Oh, my God.
But that is.
Oh, my God. Oh, the helmet comes off. Oh, my God.
But tell him what it is.
All right.
You got to explain it.
Aunt Beru.
They can't see it.
Aunt Beru
on
a pedestal and her helmet comes off. Oh, you can't talk about his wife, can you?
I told you to forget.
All right, no wife talk. But see, I don't like people that can't joke about their wives.
That's no
fun.
No,
because like Owen's the guy that would get mad if you like.
Yeah,
hey,
don't look at her. Don't look at her.
You looked at her wrong.
Hey, are you looking at her?
You have given me a diecast again. You know what I like.
The diecast
limited
is
edition.
Good.
Limited edition. Good.
Vintage finish.
Darth Vader.
Darth Vader.
Oh, beauty.
It is beautiful, and it's got its own hermetically sealed. Case.
The helmet comes... Yeah.
Plastic case.
The helmet comes off. Oh, I can't wait to...
There you go.
I
we
can't wait.
We both got things we want.
Yes. More
yes.
things for my cleaning lady
yes.
to think I'm nuts with.
This one has got to just go in the studio somewhere
totally.
Because,
totally.
You know, it's...
Yep,
it's,
definitely.
It's... Oh, I thank you for letting me out of the bubble pack.
Mr. Bubble, beautiful studio.
Do you think they suspect we're going to be in the studio?
I don't know.
We'll never retire that one. That'll be way down on the list.
It's got that'll be like at episode 150.
You know how much that hurts to hear that?
No, it doesn't hurt. Don't say it hurts. Nothing hurts. I mean, if I hit you, it hurts.
No, not if you hit me, buddy. Come on. You're combat level 1 in real life. Yeah. All right.
Yeah, and you're combat level what?
90? 90? 90? Yeah, okay. Excuse me? 90?
You're a double elite
I'm 100,
boss.
100, yeah. All right. Those are great calls again.
Those were very good calls.
You got
calls.
Great presents. Thanks,
guys. Wait.
What?
Well, what are we talking about?
We're talking about we exchange gifts. There's a. Do we have any other scrappy little calls we could play there? Anything that would fit?
I suppose we could do something here.
I think we could do something there.
All right.
Happy 50th podcast to Yivvits and MrBubble. Yeah. Love, Iskra. Oh, and by the way, Larry, have you found that drive-in theater for the double date yet?
Oh, Iskra.
Wait a minute. I thought. Well,
Iskra.
First, we'd always been saying Iskra.
Yeah.
But I thought Iskra was a female tune controlled by a male.
Well, play it again. You be the judge.
Happy 50th podcast to Yivvits and MrBubble. Love, Iskra. Oh, and by the way, Larry, have you seen that
about?
Theater for the double date?
Oh, at one of our parties. Iskra wants to go on a double date with me and Keiichi and you. You know the Wookiee Keiichi?
Yes.
We just need a four people
clarify,
vehicle.
We're talking about our in-game personas here.
Of course, what do you think I'm talking about?
I'm just clarifying for people that have never listened before.
Oh, right.
You have your in-game
You got
persona.
A little cartoon on the screen. Yeah exactly. Just picture those cartoons. It's like playing with action figures, and we're lame. But yeah. No, but picture like the in-game little vehicle, because there are some four-player or more vehicles, right?
Yes.
Of course. That's yes. What it will load it up. Yep. Me and Iskra. You
eight,
and
I think, in fact. Is,
well,
is
that'd
six
be
or eight?
Too many. Yeah. That's too many. Yeah. That'd be for the security guard and all that
such. Corvin will go back.
That's funny. Great. I'm glad she called. That's awesome.
Yep. Iskra.
All right.
What?
Mm-hmm.
Iskra. Make sure I say that correctly.
From now on, Iskra.
Oh, hey.
Oh,
that
my
means
God.
We just got a voicemail.
That's in. A huge one if that thing goes off.
I don't know what that means, but yeah, let's find out, I guess.
Might as well
I'm a little scared. I'm worried.
I know.
Long distance communication. For Yivvits and MrBubble, please enter authorization code.
Okay.
Now, code verified. Receiving file. Speech samples on file. Beginning serial to basic translation. Now,
serial.
Greetings, broadcasters. This is your old pal, Tutone.
Oh,
Tutone. I could be wrong,
Tutone.
But I detected a bit of a hint in last week's show that you might like me to call you. Congratulations on your 50th episode.
He has a speech impediment.
I, for one, am impressed with your commitment to the project so far.
Yeah. And mechanical interpreter.
I hope there's at least twice as many episodes to
He's
come.
Like Stephen Hawking.
All things being equal, if anything to
more
do with
is Stephen Hawking.
More hairy, though.
I was simply a vessel. You two maniacs brought the content to its current level. No one can take that away from
one
you.
Of is.
And I couldn't be more proud to know you both.
Aw.
Maintaining a balance of facts, fun, and just enough silliness is hard when things go like they have gone the past year.
Mm-hmm.
Again, congratulations on your 50th episode. I remain humbled, and I thank you for all of your kind words over these many months. In short, keep the good work coming, guys. You are saving our little corner of the galaxy, one party at a time.
Wow.
Fa fa fa. I slay me. Slash Snicker, slash Blue, slash 95, to Don Miles, to Yivvits, and MrBubble.
I think he's doing emotes.
Totally. The translator didn't know what to do with those, so just read it.
He just wrote them in.
Well, that.
That's Two-Tone.
That's Two-Tone. The Wookiee, very famous Wookiee.
That's Two-Tone.
On Valison.
That, I was kind of hoping we'd actually get to talk to him, but you know, I mean, what can you do? I mean, sounds like he wants to keep his privacy.
It'd be like John Smedley.
Wait, the phone's ringing.
Oh my God! Could that be John Smedley?
Are you gonna get it?
Oh heck yeah! On our 50th, let's get it.
Hello, thanks for calling Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and MrBubble. How may I help you today?
Greetings, podcasters.
Oh, it's Two-Tone.
It really is.
It is, or the puppet master known as Two-Tone.
Yep.
Out from behind the veil.
Yep. From behind.
So you
the fan.
You control Tutan's the character on the screen and type everything he says.
Absolutely.
And see, I say it that way because we really think of Tutan as somebody. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? You do it so well. It's just Tutan's Tutan.
Exactly. I have a hard time drawing the line between, you know, a real person and, I mean,
yeah.
I don't know. It is just Tutan.
For people on other servers, I mean, Tutan is a Wookiee that we know on Valsin that it comes in. It just everybody enjoys.
Comes to our parties.
Doesn't talk much, but.
And we talked about him on many episodes of our show. Oh, and we have.
I have yet to thank you guys personally for that, the kind words that you've had for the many months, said earlier.
It's the least we can do. When did you first hear of us?
Ah, good question.
Let's see. Right around the same time I heard of iTunes, which has been floating out there for a while. But, you know, when they plugged in the podcast,
yes,
that's the instinct is to, you know, type in keywords for things you like.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Guess what?
And I think we beat that by a week maybe or so, because I heard they were putting that in iTunes, and that's when I hit up Yivvits for that. It was going to be big, and we were both playing the game. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good idea. Yeah.
So, did you catch us at episode one? Do you remember?
Absolutely.
Oh, I feel sorry for you.
Yeah, I'm amazed you made it to episode two. That's awesome.
At the time that I punched in Star Wars into the, you know, iTunes podcast search engine, it only came up with 3 hits at the time, which now, you know, that's not true.
Really?
Yeah.
But you guys and, another well-named podcast. And then there was the, the well-funded outfit that was short-lived.
Right.
Right. Two-tone pop filters.
Oh, of course. We can't stop talking about them.
We talked about it probably every other episode for the last 20 episodes.
It's a low-tech solution for a common problem.
We're such noobs.
Yeah. And I can still look up on the shelf over here.
Yeah, there it is, yeah.
And I can see the first set of pop filters we had
yep.
made of small quilting or needlepoint things
right.
from Walmart and pantyhose.
From
your mom.
My mom? Who lives out of state? I don't think so. Your mom, who lives 5 blocks away, likelier. Yeah, come on. Anyway.
But, I mean, that was just like...
Oh, that was huge.
That was huge for us.
I gotta say, not only was it huge, but that just inspired us. Cause, like, such a cheesy little solution, which I thought at first. Because, believe me, you told us, like, right away to do them. And we dawdled and dawdled. And then and one day, Yivvits is like, hey, here, check it out, let's try them out. And it's like, oh my god, they actually work.
Wow, that made a difference.
Yeah.
That's incredible.
Yeah. Tutan, what do you want us to keep doing? Just the whole thing, or what?
Well, it's not so much the method, I think, as the intent. You guys have done something that Sony failed to do in 3 years, and that's build a cohesive community outside of whatever they decided to call content. Ah,
gotcha.
Hmm.
Gotcha. Intrigued.
That's very nice.
You can mention the name Yivvits and Bubble or Yivvits and MrBubble. Sorry. It's a MrBubble. in the name and casual conversation, almost any sector of Valsin, to be sure, and on several other servers, as I've been told.
Really?
And it's an instant recognition. It's you know, like wearing the right little animal on your shirt or the right team.
You know, I can't get the smile off of Yivvits' face right now. That's cute. I mean, it's great.
But I'm honored.
Because it's a virtual world, it's just hard for us to pick up on that sometimes, you know?
You said the right phrase, world. Mm-hmm. Tutan lives in a world.
Yeah, right.
Tutan doesn't participate in a game. We come to this place because it's a place, not because it's right. a thing, something we do.
Mm-hmm. Right, right.
In that place is separate from, you know, that's the true. Goals and everything. Yeah. And you guys have really done a lot.
It's really nice to hear that... that people enjoy what we do that much, you know?
Feedback's good. It's hard to get... In a virtual world, it's weird to get...
honest feedback.
Yeah, right, that too.
You know, yeah.
You know what I like is our silly... Because I consider you in the cast of characters, and I've seen it when people come to parties, and they're like, oh, there's Tutan, because they hear you on the podcast. And like Iskra, you know, like
sure. There's Iskra,
the very hot Imperial commander. Oh my gosh, she's hot as a tune. The funny thing is, like our piloting thing is, that people will come to those and they're like, oh my god, there's Iskra.
Iskra, Pona.
There's Pona.
Hello. No, so I mean, yeah,
Pona.
Tutan is forever part of our show,
right
now. So done. Whether or not you like it, it's there. But it's a good thing you do like it.
To do it, this is the 50th anniversary. You're the only caller in this whole show. What does that tell you? Are you going to be able to sleep tonight, or that excites you, or what?
Well, I may shed a bit.
Humble.
Yeah. We all shed when we're a little excited.
Those little 3M pet roller, hair roller things. You go through a lot of those.
Wookiees use a lot of those, don't they?
What are those called? Rollers? Or what?
Lint roller.
Lint roller. There are tons of those, yeah.
Yeah.
Of course, 2 tons is the size of a 50-gallon drum.
Pretty much, yeah.
2-liter bottle.
Yeah.
I do want to give a quick shout-out to Gigahertz and Agent Smith and all of the guys who helped 2-Tone really begin, because Clueless doesn't even approach my original playing style. And not only did they help me develop it by kind of showing me how to find a place, but you know, we also held a few hands on our way up too. Some of the older guys in the game, guys and gals, sorry.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Some of the older players will definitely remember being associated with some of the Gigahertz, and they're all gone now. And if they're out there and they're listening, look, I locked up the guild hall. I go in every week and dust everything off. It's just like you left it. If you want to come back, guys,
That is still there outside of Bestine, huh?
I'm the last official surviving member of Gigahertz.
Oh my God.
As far as I know, and I've sort of entrusted myself as the steward. I'm not even.
This is where 2-Tone rocks. Like this kind of stuff. That rocks, by the way.
I'm just awesome. Waiting for the boss to get back.
I have a tear in my eye. I'm not kidding. That is so sweet, man. That is great, man. Look at this. Actual tear of it. Check it out.
Yeah, it's an actual tear.
Nice. Salty.
Salusty.
Salusty tear, yeah.
I'd like to commend Gigahertz as a whole on. I was really a sort of a junior member, and then the membership melted, and that left me as the sole survivor.
Give the Wookiee the key.
Yeah.
I'm out of here.
Yeah, so it's like giving your dog the keys to your house. And going, oh, take care of this place while I'm gone, Dave.
And he's like, we'll be right back, 2-Tone. Yeah, we'll be right back.
Okay.
Life got better when I figured out how to use the can opener.
Oh, yeah.
You still stand by the window waiting for the car to come back, though, right?
Absolutely.
The little hover bike is like, oh, when are they coming back?
Oh, is that them? No. Is that them? No.
So anything else you have it here for Mr. 2-Tone?
Well, I mean, there's so many things I'd like to ask 2-Tone, but I guess we should probably get... I mean, our cake is getting kind of crusty over here, so better eat that
really
up.
Really wish you were here.
Thanks a lot, 2-Tone. It was a pleasure.
Yep. Least I could do, guys. Keep it up.
Thanks. Thank you. Wow.
Oh, what are the odds?
That was great. 2-Tone.
That's better than Smedley.
Mm. Yeah, I mean, because 2-Tone has been there for us a lot.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, we've all been through it many times, but...
No, but he's cool. He's super cool.
He's very cool.
He's got his own bunch of fans now with the show.
I'm glad that he decided to call in after we got the cryptic message.
Right.
You know, because... Frankly, the emotes are funnier if he's actually, you know, saying them, but, you know, it's hard to, you know.
I slay myself. Slash bow. Slash.
Oh, thanks, 2-Tone.
2-Tone's awesome. Big part of the show.
Yeah.
Appreciate the call.
Yep. Hey, where'd my little sheet go that says what we're doing?
Oh, I don't know.
Where did it go? No.
That's why you're disorganized.
Oh, I don't know what the problem is. Yivvits Wookiee, I didn't know where his sheet went.
Now, speaking of that kind of stuff.
Okay.
The future.
Oh, the future.
Do you have any comments on the future of this heap?
Kind of like where it's heading in the next, like, 5 minutes?
Yeah.
Because I don't know where it's going.
Well, that we never know. But we for sure know the next couple of weeks we're taking off.
Well, we're having, like, a 2-week break.
Yeah. Little hiatus.
Little hiatus.
Regroup.
But people seem to not listen all the time because we've always said it's only, like, a 2-week, and people are, like, freaking out, like... No, you got to come back. Or if you come back, it's like, no, there's no if. No. I mean, unless, like, the game shuts down, which you never know, but I hope.
Are you saying the game's going to shut down? Don't say that.
We're still going to do it. So just we need, like, a 2-week break to just, you know, reset and play some more.
And
we're moving into a different studio.
Right.
A real studio.
Right.
Although, you know, when we first moved, when we were in podcast combat level 7.
Right.
We came downstairs, and then we were, you know, now that we're 50, we get the real studio.
Right, yeah.
Well, not a real studio. That's at, that's at level 100.
We have access to drop items in it now.
Yes, yes. Yep.
So we can now drop
items. You gave me admin rights.
Right. I mean, before we could go in there, but it didn't. Nothing. We couldn't move anything.
I just make sure you pay your maintenance on time.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah.
We might not have a studio too long.
No, yeah. But that's during the 2 weeks we're going to do that. It's going to be more comfy, and the equipment is going to be better, and all sorts of things. Just logistically better.
It's going to be like the difference between today's show and episode one, but two times better.
Oh, wow.
Two-tone. Two-tone's better.
Can I tell you one benefit of making it nice and pretty and all that? Because right now, this is where we are now. It's horrible. It's my basement. Come on. I mean, I'm not going to say. Oh. It's where I dump all my junk. Yeah. You know? Yeah. All right. And float away with the rest of the garbage. Then he's like, nice. I love that Hanalea bit, don't you?
Like, oh, you know, I had to think about it for a
really?
Minute.
Really?
Yeah,
oh,
I did.
You noob.
I did have to think about
it. You noob.
Ah, shut up.
All right. Anyway.
I told you to forget it.
But here's the thing. You planted a bug in me. I think we got to get some... We got to kick it up a notch locally, and be cool to get like a news crew in here, wouldn't it?
A news crew.
No, seriously. And if we had the studio upstairs, on the record, a goal for next
okay.
year. A big goal. All
right.
Like one of our local news stations, because we can pitch it because we're such Star Wars nerds, and then we got this podcast.
See, I don't know if I want to be on the news about
Dude,
that.
Dude, please.
It's a little embarrassing.
There's no such thing as bad publicity with this kind of stuff. It's all good. It's all good. So that'd be fun. That'd be a reason. In the future, though, I also hope to like. Maybe do some recording out at our little meetup groups and places like that.
Yeah.
We could go to
an interview.
Yeah, like if we ever went to like a Star Wars thing or whatever, you know, or Best
If they ever had an official one in Minneapolis, which they'll never do.
No.
Because they couldn't have one in Chicago.
Right.
Top choice.
Be nice to have on our phone interviews more focused stuff.
Well.
Or quicker calls, because we just like to talk.
Oh, yeah, but that's us.
And these are people we like in the game. And
that's
we've
us.
Had, yeah, I know. But we get it. If you ask me, we gotta just get a few more. Just we could, just do
right.
something.
Okay,
right?
Yeah.
you've noticed like the bookends on our show.
Oh, we have bookends.
Last two. Yeah.
So what those are called?
Yep.
Are they bumpers or bookends? Or?
I think we should ask Two-Tone.
Two-Tone
I don't
know.
Might know. In my mind, they're bookends, but they're probably bumpers, aren't they?
Well,
he can pull a donut out of it.
I think that was on our cut stuff. I don't know if that's right. You know what that is.
But but we're gonna probably you'll probably hear. I mean, we're gonna revamp the structure of it a little
but
bit.
You know what? Don't scare them. You're scared.
No,
of,
it's just
they're
just,
going. No, don't.
I want them
change,
to know that we're
change.
Not just going away and going water skiing or something. We're just the break is to recharge our batteries and rethink our lives. No, to
Mr. Bubble, you just don't change.
Oh, stop that!
Stop that!
All right. For my tune, my Mr. Bubble in game. Big changes.
Oh, what?
I'm kidding. Hairdresser. No.
You're going to just stand. You're going to hang out in the ID tents in the cities.
Right.
That aren't used anymore, you know? That nobody goes there.
I forgot about those. Yeah. They're still there, aren't they?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, but
made sense of that. You had to go there to get something done.
Sure. Like,
you know, God knows you wouldn't want to have to actually go anywhere to do something.
Yeah. Yeah.
Great. Pretty soon, I hope they have it like so everything in the game, it just happens right where you are.
Oh, yeah.
It comes to you.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah.
I'm going to detach it. Mr. Bubble's just going to be a pilot, I think, and then just everything else social. I don't know if that means entertainer or what, but...
Really?
Yeah.
So no more crafting.
Well, for Mr. Bubble. For Mr. Bubble. Yeah. I got my other alt, Ralph. He's going to do everything else. It only makes sense.
He'll do all the cool stuff, though.
Are you changing anything with Yivvits?
Nah, I'd say Yivvits the same thing.
It just frustrates you, though.
I can't change Yivvits. I mean, Yivvits would be back to shipwright if I could let go.
You're monk on that, though, right?
Yeah, but... Yeah, exactly, because the crafting bugs are still there
for
resource calculation.
Right.
Which, I've gotten confirmation they didn't know about it, but, you know, like everything else, we might change it in a few months, so you're screwed for now.
But there's still some very successful, very happy
shipwrights. So that's me. But I'm just saying, it's the principle of the thing.
I understand.
All right,
okay, so what are that? Are you working on any other podcasts?
I don't know what I'm going to do.
No other podcasts or anything?
Just the Hello Kitty Online
That'd
podcast. Yeah, and then the... let's see. Andy Griffith Online.
Andy
podcast.
Griffith.
Oh, not another one.
Oh, my God.
They keep coming in.
I love these. These are good ones, though.
They keep coming in.
These are good.
Congratulations on 50 episodes of the King. Thank you. Bye.
I love that one.
He called back.
Oh, I love that one. That's too funny.
We have to think of a nickname for him.
Yeah, really.
How about Myung Sang or something?
Congratulations on 50 episodes of the King. Thank you.
Hi.
I think his name is Yang.
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 It's Yang.
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 Thanks for calling Yang.
That's what he's saying. Yang. From Yang, he says.
It's so good to make fun of the way people talk. Yeah. That's so...
Well,
I'm kidding.
We make fun of the Nemodians all the time.
Oh, do you think?
Do you think that's a spitting attack?
All right.
No. Well, we better get these out of the way.
Yeah.
Yivvits and MrBubble, congrats on the 50 episodes. Huh? Would have thought you all were kicked out of the basement by now.
What, I wish.
Tom.
Good stuff. What?
Hey. Tom. Tom.
Oh, Tom has phone skill problems.
Tom, are you a phone noob?
What was that all about?
Poor Tom.
Oh, Tom, we'll have to work on that.
We love you, Tom, but that's kind of funny. Yeah.
God, they keep coming in.
I love it.
What did you advertise in, like, the white pages or something?
I don't know. Yeah.
Hello? Yeah.
Oh.
This is the governor of California calling to congratulate you on your epic journey to the 50th episode of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and MrBubble. I must go now. Some girly politicians need to be terminated. Congratulations. Well, bye now.
Well,
you
nice,
know, I got to thank, you know, Governor Schwarzenegger.
Very nice.
Take the time out of his schedule.
Very nice.
To, you know, I mean, he must be a fan.
I would think so.
Yeah, that or else he's investigating us or something. I don't know. for fraudulent podcasting.
Right.
You know. What else do you want to talk about, MrBubble? It's our 50th episode.
I know. Let's maximize this.
Well, how do you want to maximize it?
Cake?
No, well, we did the cake. Even though we say that it's about us,
we'd
take a moment because we're obviously playing all these things for a reason because you guys listen.
And, of course.
And
now you're being so Minnesota.
No, but listen, but I don't want people to think like, oh, all they did was play some things, some clips. This is important to us because this is how we, you know, are what we are.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense?
How does that make it about us?
It doesn't.
Okay, no. Of course I hear you. It's all about the fans, of course. Of course, Billy. Yeah,
MrBubble.
But we're
it's
Minnesota.
Your problem.
No, I have no...
Lilith has been a bad, bad girl.
Yeah, she has. She's been bad. This is great.
Gosh.
This is a great one.
Hey, you know
what?
We'll just keep going with these calls, Bob.
Yeah, let's do
make another block.
Yeah, let's do
another
block
of them.
This is the last block, isn't it?
No. Well, we had to cut a couple out just because for time constraints.
Well, that's one we could fit
for anybody that called and we didn't play it. We apologize. We will probably maybe play them in the future. Maybe
never
we'll
know.
Dump them on the end of the episode. Who
okay.
knows?
Never know.
So.
Hello, Mr. Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Mr. Canaryville. I would like to wish you a happy 50th episode. You guys have been great. And I'll emote the salute to 50 more. Bye-bye.
Hey, guys. This is Ty Tobb from the Eclipse Galaxy, fellow Wookiee. Just wanted to congratulate you guys on a great show and 50 episodes. I enjoy listening to you every week and agree with all your rants on the lack of direction and bug fixing in the with the whole SWG stuff. So great podcast. Thanks a lot, and we'll talk to you soon.
Hi, this is Gal from the Valfin Galaxy, and I wanted to tell you guys that you do a great show, and I'm so glad you do it. And congratulations on your 50th episode. Keep it up, you crazy alien. Bye.
Hi, MrBubble and Yivvits. This is Prona from Valfin. Just congratulations on the 50 episodes, and we'll look forward to the next 50. Maybe on the 100th, I'll come in live to the studio and shave Yivvits. All right, take care. Bye.
Hey guys, this is Martin from the Valfin Galaxy. Just wanted to wish you guys a happy 50th episode. And just a curiosity, when do you start with the chapters? Have a good one, guys.
Chim Chimini, Chim Chiminaroo.
Pona calls.
Pona. Hello, Pona.
We like our callers.
Thank you, Pona.
Pona's fun.
Pona's great. All of them are great.
Yeah, those are all so sweet. I appreciate that.
We love them.
The happy birthday joke.
Mm-hmm.
What else?
We had lots of stuff.
That's good, though.
It's an honor, actually. Mm-hmm. So, hey, you know, what's like some of your favorite moments? through the past.
In life or what?
Well, no, there's not many
of
those.
I'd say
I'm
summer
sure.
of 87 was pretty good.
Okay. Yeah. Well, how about in on our podcast?
Oh.
Yeah, that would be the one.
Oh, God. We had so many. The one, I guess anyone, dude, where we just would crack each other up and just have a blast recording it.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, to be fair, we've done a bunch of them, and everyone sounded great when we played in that, but there have just been like 5 or 10. I can't put my finger on it. There are about 5 or 10 that during it is just an absolute blast, and we're on our rolls and all that stuff. You know? Yeah. Those seem to be fun.
Yep. Yeah. I think it has to do with the amount of Snapple ingested.
Or other, any liquids, yeah.
Any caffeine.
Because I've been experimenting. I've been experimenting with the mix, and yeah. Right. Because
your mix is 2 Snapples, a Diet Pepsi, and a piece of cake.
No, I had some, yeah, all sorts of
something
it.
Like that.
Whatever.
Or,
yeah, right.
Or Coke Zero or whatever. Yeah. Or Red Bull.
Right, yeah, those are fun. I don't know why those were so stupid, but that was fun.
The Christmas episode still was a lot of fun.
That was a blast, yeah.
And like you said, anyone, we're having a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes I also enjoy the ones where I get on a really good rant.
Yeah.
Because sometimes the rant,
fun
it always turns out fun.
Yeah.
For the listeners, but sometimes I just can't form what I want to say.
Right.
But other than that, what sometimes I just gets like,
mm-hmm.
The last couple ones were just,
just make you want to, oh, and I'm with you, baby. Yeah.
And Bagel Bites.
Those
who can
fine.
Forget Bagel
Those
Bites?
Kind of things.
The
yeah.
communion.
It's
wafers.
The things you can't plan, because believe it or not, our script is like one page, and it's never typed out.
It's not really a script.
No, it's just an outline of what we want to talk about. So, yeah. So the good stuff is stuff we can never predict.
It just happens.
It's
magic.
It just happens.
It's absolute
it's like
magic.
A magician doing card tricks.
Yeah, exactly like that, but different. Because those things are planned, right?
Right.
Exactly.
Right.
You know it.
Uh-huh.
Jar Jar, he really likes our show.
I love Jar Jar.
Yeah.
I've got,
he loves it.
It's... You know, I can remember the one we've lately had a lot of fun with was that.
That one was good.
Jar Jar. Because that was after we watched an entire episode.
Phantom Menace.
We actually took notes while watching it. We should do that again.
Took notes.
During the break. Let's watch it. Let's watch Clones, okay?
Okay, we'll do that.
With notes. We'll take some notes and have some laughs.
Take notes?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because people like when we do the movie stuff.
Yeah, and those.
Movie stuff.
Yeah, and those can, right.
Because it gets away from the game for a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But it's Star Wars.
Uh-huh.
It's still Star Wars.
Star Warsy, yep.
Oh, Misa, love it when you have play my songs.
Classic George.
Oh!
Yeah. Do you have Classic George at your fingertips or no?
Oh.
Oh, sorry. That's a great WAV file.
He's not been reprogrammed yet.
No. Classic George.
That's Classic George.
Classic Yivvits. Okay.
Classic George.
Anything else we got to do?
Let's see.
What?
What do you think?
Princess and a guy like
no.
me?
No. Oh. Those are good moments.
Throw a blanket over me. Yeah.
Yeah, those are good moments.
Yeah, right.
Just, like you said, things you can't plan. Right. Callers we've had are great.
Mm-hmm.
We love talking to them.
Mm-hmm.
Trivia, blast.
Yeah.
I mean, all in all, it's
well,
been,
yeah,
it's been
we only
fun.
Do things we like to do. So that's like saying, oh, what have you? What?
Yeah.
What good food have you had in your life? It's like, oh yeah,
I mean,
grilled cheese sandwiches. Yeah. Oh yeah, spaghetti. Oh, I had a great time with spaghetti once.
Oh, I remember spaghetti. Classic dinner. Classic dinner.
Right.
But.
Swordfish with hollandaise sauce.
Classic.
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 Classic fish dinner.
Right.
Oh.
Oh, I'm so sick of these. God. This better be good.
Hi, guys. This is John.
Yeah, it's going to be Smed.
It's me.
You fool.
No, it's me.
All right. Okay, John Smelly. Thanks for calling.
Okay. Well, right. Anyway.
Let's play it.
Hi, this is the real John Smedley from Sony Online Entertainment, and I am calling to congratulate Yivvits and MrBubble on their 50th podcast, and I wanted to say that we very much appreciate it and hope you guys keep doing it. Thanks very much, and have a good one.
Wow.
Wow. Now, there you go.
Wow.
How about that, Yivvits?
Now, I am sorry for making fun of you, Jim.
Yeah.
No, I wasn't.
No, obviously we knew that. Obviously, duh.
Yeah.
Do you think they knew?
Do you think they... Yeah, we planned the whole thing.
Don't you
thing.
Think they suspect John Smedley called?
Do you think they suspect he'll call it?
I don't know. I'm pretty sure.
John Smedley.
No, John, thanks for calling.
Yeah.
It means a lot.
That's the real deal. That was a real deal.
Yes, it was.
Yeah.
Look, he says it.
Hi, this is the real John Smedley from...
Yeah, I mean, but I could have paid my neighbor to
yeah,
say that.
Well, okay. Maybe
for
we'll...
people who know him, I mean, because...
We could, if people don't believe us, maybe we could ask him to post in the forum.
It's a real deal. Okay,
say,
sure.
Hey, it's me. It's me.
My neighbor could do that, too,
just
if he
like
knew
Han.
His password. Yeah. Hey,
oh,
it's me. Yeah.
Your neighbor could do that, too, if
Luke,
he knew...
Luke, a Jedi? Yeah. No, but that's... That's so cool.
No, and in all the things we say about Sony, and this is not just, I mean, we wouldn't have to say what I'm saying now. There's nothing that says we have to.
Right.
But we know it's a hard job, and you can't please everybody.
Right.
And, you know, we're just voicing our concerns about stuff, and that's all we can do, you know?
Yep.
So, and hopefully you don't mind, you know, being imitated and talking to Dr. Phil.
Right.
And if you don't know that happens, then maybe you need to listen to some earlier episodes.
Yeah. Or don't listen. No.
But it's all in satire. So we do appreciate you calling because it means a lot to our show.
Yeah.
And thanks.
I can't believe John Smedley called.
It was John.
How about that?
The Smed.
This is the real John Smedley.
The Smed.
Smedmeister.
The Smed.
Yeah.
That's what you call
the
him.
The Smed.
Well, I'm assuming that that's okay because, I mean, his form handle is Smed.
Right.
So.
The Smed.
Yeah.
The Greg.
We'll send him some cake. Now, about that challenge I put out that a while ago for fixing the user interface, and we'd send him Red Bull.
Oh, right.
Well, he didn't say anything about that.
No.
I don't know.
He knows.
Something tells me he probably didn't listen to that episode.
Which episode, what podcast do you think he does listen to?
Andy Griffith Online. But I do that one, like, too, so it doesn't
Armani.
Matter. No. Red Bull.
Red Bull. Okay, Red Bull.
Red Bull. Red Bull Online.
Rolex Watch Podcast.
Hi, this is Abad Kanzum from the Falcon Galaxy, and I just wanted to say congratulations on your 50th episode. Keep up the good work.
Hello, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Nikolai from the Flurry Galaxy, also known as Eric from the Eric Hour Podcast. I just wanted to call and congratulate you guys on 50 shows. I think that's awesome. I love your show. I listen to it every week and always look forward to it. And I wish you guys the best of luck. I will keep tuning in, and I can't wait to hear show number 50. Talk to you soon, guys. Bye.
Hi, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Hakate.
And Arkina.
From the Valson server, we were just calling to say...
Happy birthday!
Oh, wait. That wasn't it. What was it? What were we calling about? Oh, yeah. Congratulations on your 50th episode. Just wanted to let you know, we love your show, and keep it up. Doing a great job. Thank you.
Hey, this is Quorum from the Corbanus Galaxy. And also Jidden from the Valson Galaxy, saying congratulations, guys, on your 50th podcast. It's outstanding. You guys do a great job. You guys are really funny, keeping us entertained. So take care and keep them coming.
Hi, this is his girlfriend. I'm Zelina on Corbanus and Kaylee on Valson. Happy 50th podcast. Thanks for keeping it real.
Hey, this is Damo. Congratulations on doing 50 podcasts. Hope to hear 50 more. Might be scary at 100. Who knows? Again, thanks for all the fun and joy of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and MrBubble. Bye.
Thanks again for calling. Say it again. Say it one more time. Say it three more times or two or five or whatever you want.
It's all about the people.
Thank you. So, we're almost done.
Yes.
You know,
with this podcast. With this
particular episode.
Right.
And while I don't think we're going to go to chapters... There will be more.
Yes, 51.
Oh, I love them.
Area 51.
Podcast 51. Mm-hmm. I'll have to learn some more Roman numerals.
Yeah.
We're getting down to the end here.
Yep, and we're winding up.
We had our cake. We had our gifts.
Mm-hmm.
We talked to some fun people.
Smed called.
We got a call from Smed. Thank you, Smed. Just all sorts of fun. All
right.
A little different than usual. And... you know, you need to go and download the rest of our show, our different shows, I mean, our other episodes.
Yeah, if you haven't listened
to... Not the other show. You don't want to know our other show.
If you haven't listened to our other episodes, now's a good time.
Now's the time to start.
We're gone for a couple weeks, so...
Mm-hmm. Yes, www.swgpodcast.com, or you can go to our forums and community site at www.yivvitsandmrbubble.com.
Or you can call 651-314-4357.
Yes, sir, they sure can. It's a Skype number, it's just voicemail.
No, it's not Skype.
I mean, look, even Smedley called it.
Yeah, it's not
even
Skype,
John
though.
Called.
It's a real number.
He wasn't
number.
Scared.
We have an operator standing by. It's a real deal. It's a call center.
Yeah, no, it's not. You know, I mean, look.
What?
Smed called it.
Yeah, there you go.
Who else
if
can
it's
call?
Good enough for him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He wasn't scared.
No.
you know.
Hi, this is the real John Smedley from Sony Online Entertainment. Uh-huh.
No, thanks again, John. We do appreciate it.
Of course.
Busy guy, you know, he's got to call in.
So this is it, Yivvits?
I guess so.
I couldn't have done it without you know that. Neither of us could have done it by ourselves.
50. Yeah, 50. No. Because you'd been, you know, upstairs, just, you know.
I would have made it to maybe 3.
You wouldn't have done the right sound effects.
Oh, I probably wouldn't have done them.
No.
It would turn into, like, a different kind of podcast.
Yeah. One that maybe isn't appropriate for our audience. And don't forget.
What?
In memory of our retired.
Well, say some nice things about me. Come on.
Oh, sorry.
Come on.
Thank you, Mr. Bubble, for putting up with me.
Oh, now that's really nice. That's sweet.
Because I'm a handful. Let me tell you. Let me tell you. I am a handful.
Yeah, all right.
But thank you.
People listening are like, guys, get a room.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Now, can we touch on that quickly? Okay, we live in the same town.
Yeah.
We're in different houses. Simple as that. Jeez, stop it, guys.
God, what the hell?
Stop it with the emails and the insinuations.
Lilith has been a bad girl.
The funniest thing, though, Yivvits, in real life, though, is my neighbors know I'm divorced. I hate to keep bringing this up. My neighbors know that. And then once a week, they see this big truck. You have a big truck. Drive over to my house once a week. Some guy gets out in his upper 20s, gets out of the truck. This is, again, what they see. Some guy gets out of the truck, goes in my basement for 3 hours, and then leaves. I'm just saying. All right. Man. It's all perception. Perception is reality with some people.
Oh, man.
Anyway, so maybe this will be better.
On that note.
I know. What a nice, tender way to end this thing, huh?
I don't even forget it.
And that WAV file is gone.
It's retired.
Oh, never again.
Oh, wait.
I told you to forget
that's
it.
Okay, now it's gone.
Goodbye.
But not this.
No. I told you to forget it.
And Lilith, just...
What?
Yeah.
Lilith has been a bad girl.
You remember that, Lilith.
Yes, Lilith.
Don't forget. We'll send the mouse droid after you.
You and your sound effect. All right, Yivvits.
Hey, happy 50th.
Thank you. You too, sir.
And, you know, have fun editing this. This
will be a blast. Because
there'll be a lot of things to edit out.
Including this.
No, you got to leave that in for memory.
Oh, okay.
All right. Well, thanks a lot, Mr. Bubble.
Yeah, you too, Yivvits. It's been great.
We'll go out here with our usual music.
Mm-hmm.
And our good friend, Fingerin' Dan.
Mm-hmm.
He's always there for us with Max Rebo and the group.
The modal nodes.
Mm-hmm. The nodal modes. Thanks, Mr. Bubble. Thanks, Smedley. Thanks, all of our callers, for making us who we are.
Even though we kept joking about how it's all about us, it isn't.
It isn't. It's all about you.
Because we're chumps. If it was just if nobody listened, we'd be just really dorky. Yes. Really even more dorky.
And we'll stop professing that now. So
yeah, we're back to Minnesota mode. But no, seriously.
See you in 2 weeks.
Yep, couple weeks.
We don't want to put a number on it.
Well, no, but people are going to set their
time. You're noncommittal.
They're going to listen to this.
Noncommittal.
That too.
That's what was wrong with your marriage.
You're horrible, Dr. Phil. Who are you? Who are you, Dr. Phil?
What is your problem? I can tell you what is wrong with your marriage.
You eat too much.
Now, if you understood...
It's so stupid that I keep bringing my marriage on a Star Wars podcast.
That must mean something.
But shut up.
I don't know.
Well, I know one thing, there's... I don't even want to say it.
Oh, don't say it.
No.
All right. Bye. Thanks, everyone.
Bye.
Thank you.
Galaxies with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble is made possible by a grant from the Corellia Times. Real people, real stories, real answers.